मतलब यू सी इरफान, यू सी नवाज, मतलब वो पॉकेट भी मारा तो उसने अपना दिया ना. एक सीन यार इन सरफरोश तो वे ही क्राइड
है. तो वासन बाला फिल्म का नाम है. एक सेकंड. ओके कभी करना है सडनली भाई.
मुझे कास्ट कर लो पर ही रिजेक्टेड मी because and yeah it's true ना बोले मैरिज का लिटरली.
अभी किसी ने किस पे शक किया है.
बहुत हंस रहे कुछ लोग तो.
वो और क्या होता
है. आई वाज लिटरली स्वेटिंग एंड आई एम स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ बिग स्टार.
मतलब गुड आई गुड आई.
And since you spoke about the casting process, why did you choose Sikandar sir and why did you choose Huma ma'am?
So Sikandar always had in my mind for like the past, since I had seen Tere Bin Laden 2. So I knew that I was going to work with him, but I didn't know which film and for what. There was actually a short film happening with Ashi Dua and I had suggested your name, but that film never happened. And Ashi was like, Sikku, are you sure? I was like, yes, I'm sure. but that never happened. And over here then, there was this character and I thought I should at least talk to him and make this happen.
And he was fab. Do we agree?
So, yeah. So, had a conversation with him. I think he was in Indonesia then. He was shooting for Dev Patel's film, which is a Hollywood film. Actually, the credit first goes to Jaya Saha. Mm-hmm. I hate agents, but I have to give her the credit first. That she suggested a name. I wasn't sure then, but it was just a very casual meet wherein she says, oh, you should meet Huma. And after that, I didn't think much of that suggestion. Then Huma had come to meet Shriram. And once Shriram operates on the fourth floor, we were prepping from the second floor. And she just generally came, met. And once she left, I just asked my ADs, what do you all think? I think Monica. And they were like, yes. So.
Wasn't she fab again?
So what I have narrated just now is the most unfair of all casting processes. Because iska maine kabhi to film dekha 4 saal pehle and I thought. And she waltzed into this. So, you know, all that it just happens.
So yeah. Hearing it from you. How did you find that you're doing the film and what did you find about the films being so intriguing? What did you like about the film?
Yeah, as sir said, I was shooting. I had a long action sequence that I was doing in Indonesia. And I mean, I got a call from a casting person saying that, you know, there's this film and I was in a different frame of mind at that time. It was very, very hectic that what was happening. And I was like, listen, okay, fine. Listen, let me get back to you. But just tell me what it's about. Like, it's a Vasan Bala film and I was like, one second. Okay. kabhi karna hai. Suddenly my mood over there was a little low. And as soon as I heard that, literally, you know, like whenever for an actor, we get something that comes across, you get that excites you. So he's a maker that's always excited me. From Mard Ko Dard Nahi Hota, you know. I mean, he's truly something that's special. You know, kind of cinema I like watching. And then they said, sir, can we have a Zoom call? I said, absolutely, 100%. And I remember the Zoom call, me sitting in my room over there. And he said, and I said, sir, just give me 10 days. I remember flying by, I said, because I was doing a long sequence, which I was just going to be completely in. And I said, sir, can you share the script with me? He said, of course. He said, I said, give me 10 days, I'll read the script in 10 days. And I was flying back and I was in transit at Dubai airport for 5 hours and I literally opened that the script on my phone. I was sitting, I said, chalo dekhte hai. I didn't have a laptop or anything and phone pe kahan kuch padha jata hai. So I opened it and I said, chalo 2-4 line to shuru to karu and I started. In 1 hour, I had finished the full script on my phone. So for me, as an actor, as somebody who wants to do something, the most important thing is the film first. And if I can read that and if I can read it off my phone and I'm not that much of a voracious reader, I think that was a big win. And I mean, after that, I came back and I think we met, I think a day or two after that. And it was, a man will give his left arm right arm, any part of their body to work with Vasan. If you get a chance in life, this 30-second role that they gave me, I was very happy with it. I would like to do it again. It was just, it was a no-brainer, brother. It was a no-brainer.
Very nice.
Now,
for
them,
Talia.
Yeah, seriously.
Well, what was your process? What did you? What was your first reaction when you heard that you're doing the film, and how did you like it? What pulled you towards the whole thing?
I've known Vasan for very long. Gangs of Vasipur, when he was aiding on that film, yeah. When I was my debut film, so we kind of knew each other then. We used to hang out a lot, play cards. Do all of that, and I even acted with him in a short film that another common friend of ours, Shlok, has directed. So, but somehow I felt like when he made his first film, Peddlers, I thought was even then asking ki mujhe cast kar lo, but he rejected me because, and yeah, it's true, number embarrass you a little bit. Because, and the logic he gave me, tu bahut sundar hai, tu us world mein dikhegi nahi, sab tere ko ghurenge. So, and I gave him some very bad suggestions, you know, I'll make a buck tooth or I'll put a scar or something. Yeah, so he said, nahin, nahin, chalne nahin wala. But, and then of course, you know, Peddlers happened and then Mard Kudar happened. And when I saw Mard Kudar, I really thought like, you know, it was a very, very special film. It was very unique in terms of, and I felt like, and because I've also known him over the years as just, not just, you know, friend, but somebody who just loves films so much. And what I really, really admire in Vasan is that is he has this deep love and knowledge about films in general. Mm. And he doesn't differentiate like, oh, I only like certain kinds of cinema. Mm. He loves everything. Mm. And his knowledge is, matlab, insane. So, and it, and there's no like, and when he talks about films also, there's a sense of, I don't know, community and a sense of sharing, which is so nice. So, and I feel like somehow what he's cracked in Mard Kudar, and I think it's really crystallized, you know, which is why people are loving and enjoying Monica so much, is because he's found his own unique genre, which is his love for films in general, you know, which is clutter-breaking at the same time, you know, a gentle homage to things, mm-hmm. but also so unique. Mm-hmm. And because when I read the script, or actually I heard the script first, there was a narration that happened, I really enjoyed it, but I also like, knew that there were many ways or many interpretations to how one could direct it. Mm. But and the one that he chose was the one that none of us had imagined. When and Sikandar and I saw the film together, and we couldn't stop laughing.
We were
and
the first, no, to watch it from the
first actors. I think to watch it because Raj was not in town and none of the others were there. So we watched it and we were just rolling over, laughing so much. And there are things that I saw which were not on the page.
Wow.
You know, and sometimes even as an actor, I felt maybe I didn't even perform it, but there's another layer that was going on in his head, which was supplementing the words on the page and what the actors were performing. Like, just to give you an example, there's a scene in the film, which when we were performing, is the most absurd scene that one was doing. He, matlab, Raj baitha hai wahan pe and I'm trying to poison his tea. Or at least he thinks I'm poisoning his tea, but that's not true. Now, you know, it's so illogical. Like, there is no logic to it. It's not real. It's not possible.
Yeah, why would someone poison in front of so many people?
Exactly.
Yeah. Also.
But abhi dimag mein aa gaya. And the way he has such an enthusiasm about when he's directing actors or when he's describing a scene, I feel like I also get swept up in that enthusiasm. Like, I don't know kya hone wala hai, but chalo, let's go on this ride. You know, let's see what comes out of it. And maybe you'll fail and maybe you won't, but let's have fun with it. And then when I saw the scene and how he had edited it and with the choice of music and all of that, it just became something else. So I feel like from this experience at least, like I feel like I shot for this film for 10 days.
10 days, yeah.
You know, and I always knew what the outcome was going to be, but I feel like it's definitely one of my most favorite filming experiences, and just the love that I'm getting is insane.
Amazing.
So thank you
for
that.
Thank you.
So, when she spoke about the treatment, why did you choose to have this retro theme over the film? Was it like a very conscious choice that you knew that you would make even before you start filming, or it just so happened while you were filming?
Yeah, I think I was very sure that because anyways everyone is buying rights to Korean and Spanish thrillers and making them. So, that was very clear that that is not happening. It's the same color temperature, the same color palette, the same set design.
Yeah.
suddenly all Indians are living in hill stations. So that was never there. It had to be more homegrown noir. Like we live in a tropical climate, you know, and there is monsoon, and you know, so we accept all of that. Except the fact that we are not Hollywood cool. We are cool in our own way.
True, very true.
So, which is how a lot of those choices were made as to how the office will look, how the houses will look. Those things first. And then the retro theme is because I think India has also had a rich tradition of making great noir films. Like Vijayanand, of course, is one of them. Like who has made Soma Desh, Shriram Raghavan as well.
Of course.
So we always had, and even back then, you have films like Mahal and Howrah Bridge, and you know. So we always had this genre. It's just that now we've lost touch with the making it homegrown. I think we just feel it should just look like a Hollywood film.
True.
But actors are speaking in Hindi or mostly in English also. So I think, which is why it was just more giving an ode to the great masters from here, not just Hollywood or world cinema, but actually our own Hindi film directors and Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, everyone.
Right. So, did you give that sort of a briefing to the actors already that this is how the film is going to look?
No, no, that is not needed. They just have to, like, it's more the character, the treatment is separate. Because that shouldn't overshadow, or suddenly he shouldn't be playing it like Pran, no?
Yeah.
Like, that's not the point also.
Yeah.
The point is not to spoof.
Correct.
The point is to be real, but, somehow blend in the flavor. So, the flavor also shouldn't bother the audience. Actually, all that is for me.
Correct.
Like, and if you kind of catch on to it, then it's fine. But that is not the primary thing for the audience. The primary thing for the audience is them. And their personality through the character.
Right. So when you got the script, what was your first process to approaching your part?
Nothing, I just read the script. Yeah, I read the script, I'll read the script again. I'll read the script again. Even if my part is done, I just keep reading the script. And I think when I start reading it, it's written also so, when something is really written well, there's a lot more clarity about a character in itself. Because the way the person is speaking, it's pretty much, they say, your words are what you are.
Right.
So you can understand where the person's coming from. So if I keep reading it, I know what people are doing around. That person starts coming into me. I don't have a fixed process of writing something down or, but you see, you when you start moving on and you start reading and you realize the other person, like her, the fact that he's the stepbrother, he was married before. That has nothing to do with me. I could have just read my part and moved on.
Yeah.
But when I keep reading it and I see so much more and I start seeing that, what is their relationship? Or the relationship, he must have been a guy that's gone through stuff earlier on, Why is he like this? Why is he planning on killing somebody in this situation? He probably really needs to take stuff because he's not been given it. He needs to also protect himself, they're very much at the back. I'm just saying, this is just for me to get a vibe of the person, per se. So that, my process is just reading it again and again. And somewhere the guy just comes to me.
What about your process?
I kind of agree with what Sikandar is saying, and I feel like, and ye problem hai hamare matlab industry ki na, ki aur hota kya hai, jab as an actor aap koshish kar rahe hote to break into it, sometimes you don't get just always the lead parts, right? Sometimes you might just get like a part which is not that prominent, but if you are in a habit ki nahi aap apni sirf line padh ke jaoge, to I feel it's going to be cheating towards what you can actually offer.
Right.
So if you read the entire script in entirety, you'll understand, like, I've done a lot of ensemble films. I started my career with The Gangs of Wasseypur, which is the biggest ensemble film, I think, ever. And then, or Badlapur, or whatever. So I feel like what really helped is if you understand, if the writer or the director have written something, what is the reason for it to be over there? Right. And so just to understand the world of it, because like I said, each director, each set of people who set out to make a film will have their way of saying that story.
Right.
So it takes me at least 1 or 2 days to really understand, okay, this is what is expected from me. Because as an actor also, there's so many ways or so many tonalities or so many pitches to your character, but which one is right for this film?
Right.
And that you only figure it out, it's a collaborative process. It's not just me. It's getting feedback constantly, understanding what is working, which take has been okay. So it's a lot of that. But also, so what helps me is, of course, learning lines, because I think there's no excuse for not doing that and turning up unprepared on set. It's disrespectful to your work and to other people who are working with you. And that's the bare minimum that you should bring to the table. But also, like, not be set. कि ये लाइन मैं ऐसे ही बोलूंगी कि पॉज इधर ही आएगा बिकॉज आई फील समटाइम्स व्हेन यू गो सो ओवर प्रिपेयर्ड देन यू Screwed. Can I say that word?
Yeah.
Then you're just checking. It's a school and all. Na? I was going to say the F word, but I held back.
But it's anyway. And our film is full of it.
That is true, actually. So yeah. So just don't go with like only one way of delivering the line. I think that's very limiting. Just go with an exploration. Chalo kuch khelte. Play is important.
That is true, but because if you start rehearsing, for me also, like I have done that. Mm. I have rehearsed a full scene with the exact way how I'll do it. Mm. And then I've gone on set and it's completely, the vibe is completely different. Yeah. So I'm stuck, but now I'm stuck in that. Mm. So how do I get out of that? So just know it basically. And then the director, the scene, your co-actors, the situation, all that's going to come
in. And what you read and what, how you shoot it, there's always going to be this massive gap. Yeah. So if you're thinking, yaar, ye likha hai ki, रूम में बैठ के दो लोग बात कर रहे हैं बट वहाँ रूम में भी छत है और ट्रैफिक की आवाज भी आ रही है तो नाउ यू नो हाउ डू यू ब्रिंग योर हेड अराउंड टू दैट बट दीज आर जस्ट थिंग्स यू हैव टू डू समटाइम्स ऑक्यूपेशनल हैज़र्ड्स
सो व्हेन यू वर डायरेक्टिंग देम वाज देयर एनी डे वेयर दे डिड नॉट गेट समथिंग राइट
नो आई डोंट थिंक आई डोंट लाइक इंस्ट्रक्टिंग एनीवेज
ओह नाइस
या सो आई थिंक एवरीवन हियर ऑन सेट आई थिंक दे काइंड ऑफ नो द जॉब Also, I think, which is why the casting process is so important. Mm. Because if you've trusted them with the casting, then you trust them with the character also. And not overburden them with too much information. Mm. I think after a point, then I'll start loving my voice. Kitna kamal baat kar raha hu. Then that doesn't help the film movie. So, to trust them, yeah, they'll come, they'll perform. Or, and you'll get the vibe also. If you don't like it, then there is a polite way to say what it is. But there is never like stark and lines and all that. I think it's a lot more flexible process because when you're chasing a vision, then the vision is a much larger idea. Mm. But if you're chasing lines, if you're chasing very particular things, but then there'll be so many directors whom they'll be facing, y'all will be facing. So you'll have to adapt only.
Yes.
But here, no instructions or no getting stuck and all that. Even getting stuck sometimes could be good. So I'm very selfish. I'll use everything which is fun and magical for the film.
Right. So. But now, apart from this film, let's just say, has there been any day where you've not got it right? Can you talk about the dips and the lows more? Because I believe that it's not going to be all rosy every day. And it's not going to be all nice every day. There are going to be failures. And I think what we should learn to accept is that failures are a part and parcel of the trade. And it should not be like, you know, one little day sort of put your entire confidence down. And I think it's so important for everybody here also to know that.
But that's also human, right? Like we all have days and or we perform a scene, you go back and you're like, oh, I should have done that. Or,
That never finishes.
That should never finish.
That should not.
Because if you don't go back home and are not hungry still about like, how did I do it and did I get it right or... Like, मैं तो कभी कभी क्या होता है गो बैक एंड लाइक आई रियली मेस्ड इट अप लाइक यू नो आई थिंक आई मेस्ड इट अप बट दैट्स द फन ऑफ इट आल्सो बट यार शुडंट द आइडिया इज नॉट टू गेट योर कॉन्फिडेंस डाउन बिकॉज दे विल बी बैड डेज दे विल बी डेज लाइक समटाइम्स एज प्रोफेशनल एक्टर्स हम लोग के साथ बहुत होता है कि यू नो यू गोइंग फ्रॉम वन सेट टू द अदर समटाइम्स देयर इज अ कैरेक्टर स्पिल ओवर समटाइम्स यू जस्ट हैवंट हैड इनफ स्लीप दीज आर प्रैक्टिकल आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट लाइक जेन्युइन रियल लाइफ सिचुएशंस दैट आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू विल फेस One day I've just gone on set and I have to have two pages of dialogue and I haven't slept. Mm. So how do you, at that point in time, so yeah, you will have an off day or maybe not your best day. But the idea is that you have to, it's about discipline, it's about it's repetition, it's about just keep doing it again and again. And there is no shortcut to this. I don't think anybody can become an overnight, like a great actor. Everybody has to work really hard towards doing that.
There's no, you know, I've messed up, yeah. I've messed up damn badly times. And genuinely, I've got stuck on a dialogue. Like, I had like some 40, I had like two pages of like going on. And I had like some 30 names. Names is different names.
Yeah, harder. Yeah,
and I'm going on these names. And first take is good. And then they'll cut and they'll change it. And you got to do it again. And you got to do it again. And I pass out on one name because it's coming. ये यहाँ पे गया, फिर वहाँ से मैंने ये उठाया, फिर उसके दुकान से मैंने ये लिया, फिर उसके वहाँ से मैंने वो गैराज से वहाँ से one name went. Man, I was there shooting. One name went. I was just worried about getting that name, and I kept. And then I got stuck. And I was literally sweating. And I'm standing in front of a big star, there's a huge director sitting over there. We're on an outdoor and I'm just stuck badly. And it's like your tongue swells up. You're like, it's the worst place to be.
You blank
out. In the world. It's the worst place. Then everybody, then you're looking at everybody else's faces around on the set that they're looking at you and it's finished. You have to get out of that somehow. Sometimes there are great directors who help you, cut ke le lete hain, whatever. But you know, for me, it happened somehow, that scene happened. But I mean, they managed it somehow. But I, like, it stayed with me for so long, this situation, that when we had our scene, the long one, which I told him that it's not that one scene that I had in the film.
The monologue?
Yeah, that. So, bro, when there's something that's gotten you so badly, the others are so, you don't know this backstory of mine, what I went through. And then it was not supposed to be. I had spoken to him. I said, I hope you're not starting with this. He said, hey, don't worry. Iske saath nahi hoga. COVID hit, everything got pushed. Finally, got our dates again. I called to see if everything, everybody's okay, you know, message, etc. I said, but we're not starting with that scene. He said, yaar, uske saath hi start kar rahe hain. And that was like for me, and I was just upstairs. And the only thing that came to me was the time I got stuck, you know. So, as she rightly said, man, and for me, the most important thing is to know my lines, because then I can start playing with them and then I can do something with it. Yeah, but you know, and you have to come out of it, man. I had to fight. I was fighting a lot of demons in the room upstairs while you all were lighting up downstairs, you know. Somehow it just went, you know. I don't think I messed up on the line.
And it was like a hot little room. He was sweating profusely.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I think, which is where the trainer comes very handy, you know.
Yeah.
Because most of the time you will be battling a lot of things, and with the younger they are, woh hi relationship trouble, matlab abhi jhagda hua hai, abhi kisi ne kis pe shak kiya hai.
Bahut hans rahe kuch log to.
Yeah, woh aur kya hota hai? And you know, then you have to perform.
Ek to ro bhi rahi hai.
You have to perform, right? especially for at least the 10-15 years of your career, these are going to be your offset problems.
Yeah.
And then you all have to come and be different people and not let your crew know that you all are going through this.
Yeah.
So which is why you need to be trained, you need to, and also this, don't ever become this actors who are lost in character and all. Because no one likes that.
Yeah, they really hate it.
Unless you're Ranveer Singh, then do whatever the fuck.
No, we keep giving this gyan here, but it's like ghar ki murgi dal barabar, na?
Correct.
So now that you're saying, it adds a lot more weight.
Yeah, no, because it's not about you, it's about the film. And, you know, being lost and in the character, don't talk to me, all that.
I'm in my process. Bhai, tera process hai, baki log bhi to kaam karne hai.
Unless you're responsible for, you know, 300 crores. So, then do whatever you want, everyone will stop. But until that happens, yeah, just training every day, being aware of the technicalities of being aware if your co-actor is blocking the camera, your face, just a little bit to the left, right, so that the scene, if you feel the flow is happening, it doesn't get cut. Like, Raj is very good at that. Matlab, dheere, like, Bux was covering, he was just like a little bit.
You know, because that's...
That's it, yeah, like, you're just helping the crew. Because you never know which take is going well, yeah. Because that's the magic of cinema, yeah. Also.
Right.
You can keep doing takes, but somehow, jo out of focus hoga, sabse acha take hoga. But wo kuch nahi kar sakte. But wo kuch nahi kar sakte. So it's like a miracle only, every day on set. Right. But which is why training and being alert is really important.
Very important. In fact, I actually wanted to discuss that scene where you had this huge fight with Rajkumar Rao, and it was a very interesting scene, especially the way it's happening. Can you tell us about how you all filmed that and how that entire process
was? You should first talk about how you wrote it and how did that come about. And
no, I mean, it was it was a tricky one because it's supposed to start off as comedy. But then it's a very dark, morbid scene that, you know, someone's trying to kill someone.
Yeah.
And then it has to go through layers without it being too ridiculous. And then it has to suddenly become serious and that, you know, life might be lost, and then turn it around into some sort of a very strange relationship that they have.
Correct. Yes.
So all this had to be done within that, you know, real time kind of. And even, yeah, we were shooting third day, I think.
Second
after day. We finished the mammoth scene with him, and we directly.
My second day, film ka third day.
But
film,
I'm sure you all rehearsed that scene multiple times.
No, not multiple times. I think there was a kacha pakka rehearsal of basically Raj just had to
20
do
minutes of action rehearsal.
So Raj just had to know that, and Raj is good at that. And so he just had to, like, what kind of, because he went to let go and went to little bit of that. And then dhire dhire started doing it. But the idea is also to capture the action and not make it too, like, you know, cut at every point. So the, it's a performance and not really action.
Correct. To make it look also more very organic.
Yeah, like someone is, like, you don't know who is attacking him and who is surviving him. You know, so that, that power equation needs to keep shifting.
So what was your briefing to them when you actually...
Nothing, not too much. I don't like that either. I think they read the screen, they see the vibe of the... and it's all sabko samajh aa raha hai, koi kisko maar raha hai. And once you kind of understand the choreography,
wherein her hand is going all over his face and she's pressing the eyes, so they understand the tone. So,
Uttam, I think it was a brilliant scene. Huh?
And for me, the high point was the when Huma is pulling Raj and she grunts. That was, and that was, that that came from her. That, that was not in the brief. I think once that happened, that was like scene done. Because after that, I knew the beats, because that one thing I didn't know would happen. So that was like magical. That, because when you let go of your vanity, it is not about being feminine or looking nice, but it is saving your life. And beyond saving your life, now hurting him, who's come to hurt you. So that then landed, like, that was the perfect pitch that she only got.
Which was your favorite film?
This scene has to be my most favorite scene ever. Not just in this film, but I think in life. We had a lot of fun shooting this up. My second day of shoot, the film's third day of shoot, and you know, we just jumped into it. And like Vasan said, you know, he doesn't like to overbrief, which is great. Like, he's also instinctive like that with actors. Like, he'll only, like, the only time I think he kinda, I wouldn't say brief me, was when he made me on my first day say that line. Say ma Monica or my darling. It's not there in the script. So suddenly he comes and says, "Bol na Monica ja meri." So I'm like, but kaise, matlab, it can sound really like weird. Like, will I? You know, when that's the only time he sort of explained what the reference he was going for. But that was, of course, to work with an actor like Raj, who's phenomenal. And he's such a, you know, supremely, I don't know, confident actor. And I think he's just so, like, secure. Because I know for this first scene, like this to do, where literally we are slamming each other, you know, and we just went for it, and we had so much fun, and there's a lot of give and take. I think there's a lot of, like, and it was just, it's really nice to just explore all those beats with another person in the room. And the crew was amazing that day. Remember, everybody was really, like, there was, matlab, bahut kam hota hai, you know, set pe pin drop silence, but that day everybody was just so aware. It was a little, not a very big room, matlab, itna, but there was just a amazing energy in that room. And as actors, sometimes when you're doing some these very vulnerable scenes, ki matlab pit bhi rahe ho and actual lag bhi rahi hai, aap gir bhi rahe ho, emotional bhi hai, funny bhi hai, you know, aur wo sab hai, I just felt like everybody was just so aligned. Like, and that feeling na, as an actor, when you feel like, oh, everybody just wants me to give my best shot.
It's a
very beautiful feeling. Then you are just in the moment. Then you're not thinking about anything. You're not thinking outside. You're just thinking, okay, I'm going to stay true and committed to what I'm supposed to do. This guy's killing me. Now I have to do whatever. Now that only happens when you're not conscious of people. You're just, everybody's, I thought everybody was, you know, Swapnil was in the scene, the sound guy's in the scene, he was in the scene. Like, there's a moment both of us fall down and, like, you know, I think I was not supposed to have tears, but I had tears because of exhaustion. You know, which took, became something else. And Vasan was like, just hold him, touch his hair. So I've just touched his hair and then I've held him. Raj also, instinctive actor, he's also held me. Now suddenly it's become a romantic moment.
Yeah, which is where the training helps. Like, you know, even if you're in between, you understand you're rolling. Of course, you can cut and start, but you'll never get the magic back. So, so just being instinctive really helps here.
Oh, have you planned it yet?
No, no, not at all. It just started and then we went with the flow and then that became the scene.
Wow, wonderful.
And also, that was a great fall, yeah. Once you run from there, and that's like proper stuntman fall, stunt person fall,
Sir, aapka jo scene tha, room number 303, if I can recollect it right. And you had this long monologue and it was done in darkness. Of course, you spoke about how you were battling demons at that particular time. Was it the same scene? How long did you guys shoot for? Did you rehearse it in?
Talking about that scene, never mind that. What I was thinking about recently was that, you know, a lot of times we're doing scenes and all as actors, and especially if they're two or three and it's a scene like that. I was thinking of this and it came to me so much later that we usually rehearse for timing.
Correct.
Exactly.
Most of the time when there are more people, because everybody has a tone. And you're saying it and there's give and take and there's timing involved in this scene also. You know that ye bol raha, wo bol raha, ye bol raha. So usually do it with actors. I realized, sir, we didn't rehearse it.
Wow.
We did, and I realized this recently, there was no rehearsal. He enters, we enter, but it just starts, he's giving his thing, my thing is going on, Bucks has entered. At no point, sir, did we sit and we didn't even run lines.
I hate rehearsals anyway.
We didn't run lines, and I was like, dude, that's insane, because Raj was giving back to what I was giving. Suddenly Bucks came and he gave it back. Your one thing came, you can give the smile over here, I remember, which was going on in there. So that was really cool, you know, organically, the timing, that three people, firstly, for it to actually match in a situation like that with timing is a rarity.
But I think it was beautiful because you didn't rehearse. You know,
you're possibly right.
Because possibly sometimes right. When you're doing that, na, you are something, you also don't know what's going to happen.
Correct.
So, kuch magical hi
aata hai. And the thing is, but kabhi kabhi, just to get that timing right, you might need one or two more takes.
Correct.
But at no point were we taking, we did do more takes.
Yeah. Correct.
But the take was not because the sur was off of any one of us.
Correct. It was for other reasons.
You know
reasons.
What I'm saying? We had one reading, That this one reading we had and nothing else. So, it was really cool. Like, I look back and I'm like, dude, that's so cool that there were. Because nobody's acting alone, we're with everybody else, and when it just fits.
Because also, I don't treat anything as dialogue-based comedy. Mm. So, which is why I don't believe in that pat-pat wala, very Gujarati stage rehearsal. Because they are incredible at it. Yeah. Gujarati and Marathi stage, they are outstanding.
Correct.
They can like say anything, pani, and make it comedy. So that's anything. Yeah, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, so which is what like Rohit Shetty's style is from there, like, which is where that crossfire happens. But here it is more character based, and I don't expect everyone to laugh at things that I find funny.
True.
Eventually, if they find it funny, I'm.
But like, did they laugh when you, because the things that you have in your head, did people laugh when we had whatever?
Lots of places.
They did.
Lots of places. Yeah. Which is great because I don't react in that manner while shooting.
Yeah, no, you give no reactions.
No,
So we're like, are we messing up or not messing up? Like, he gives no reactions. He doesn't even say, okay,
because he's so busy doing the bottle flip, guys.
Yeah. You know, but it's like almost like you're not there. But it's very easy also in a way. Like, at no point was there that pressure of like, you got to get it right. You don't give that. Like, I mean, you know how to handle.
But there's no right or wrong, actually.
Which is what you said, there's no bad thing.
There is no bad thing.
Yeah.
There's no bad thing.
So what makes you actually say an okay to the take?
So if I've got, for the scene, I feel, and also I'm not too rigid about the scene mostly, but there are some places where you feel you're rigid because otherwise it becomes too much of a logic bomb. Mm. Within the world, that is, world of the film, I don't think there is any bad take. Be accepting of the people's personality also.
Right.
I think which is why casting is so important.
Right.
Because you don't limit an actor just for the line and I think everyone has one great moment. Even a non-actor has one great moment in cinema. Mm. Like everyone has wo sab ke isme likha hai.
Correct.
But I think the more you give space to put in their personality, I think there's more life.
Very wonderful. In fact, we were just talking about it.
Yeah, I think personality is more important than lines and character. Because a lot of people have started writing, this character loves magenta. I think that's bullshit. Or, ye ramen mein sirf itna aadha masala kaat ke khata hoga. Yeah, all that is shit. Adds zero to character.
Maine kuch kiya tha, usme bola tha ki ye sirf character sirf red gems khati hai. मैं बोला जेम्स का टेस्ट सेम होता है रेड खाओ या येलो खाओ
मतलब या मेकिंग इट वेरी स्पेसिफिक डजंट मीन क्लैरिटी हां
या आई थिंक इट कॉम्प्लिकेट्स द एंटायर प्रोसेस
नथिंग इट जस्ट मेक्स इट रिजिड एंड वन नोट
राइट
एंड वी आर नॉट देयर वी आर सो मेनी डिफरेंट थिंग्स मी सिटिंग हियर इज डिफरेंट दे सिटिंग हियर इज डिफरेंट एट होम दे विल बी डिफरेंट विद देयर फ्रेंड्स दे विल बी डिफरेंट सो आई थिंक दैट इज व्हाट शुड होपफुली कम आउट
Correct.
And then maybe make your characters as non-judgmental as possible. Mm. Maybe.
Mm. Right. Great. Any questions here? Nishan.
Hi, first of all, I like the shoes.
Thank you.
I have two questions, but one of the scenes which you were discussing about, it was one of my favorite scenes. So I really like the detail which you added where after the spanking, I think you kind of changed your voice. That was nice, and also Rasmussen also where he looks at the mirror and then
she had a bad throat that day while coming.
I really like the scene. Now I'm not going to explain. I have one question for you. You talked about rehearsing something, you rehearse and then you go like, you know, you forget. The moment when it doesn't work the way you want it to work. When you over rehearse a particular scene. So you told about that, but how did you get out of that?
By getting out of overhearsing, I just have to know my lines. I know that I just have to, because I went through that. I overrehearsed and then I was just stuck because I had practiced it so much that when I reached set and I was there, the whole situation is different, but I've rehearsed it so much, it's almost become now I'm not being able to get out of it. So I realized that was not helping me. I'm not being able to do what I'm supposed to do. I'm actually just, it's hampering my work. So I just realized that I just have to know my lines. Once I know my lines and I know the scene, then the director and then the situation, and when I put on my costume and when I'm over there, if I want to play with the bottle or I want to, touch something like that. So you just have to know the lines here. Just know the lines. Because the director is going to come and tell you, what if I've practiced just doing this 10 times? And the director is like, I don't want you to do this. I want you to just do this on that line. Lag gaye. I just realized that's the problem, and then it's damn easy because not practicing is fine. If I don't practice it, then it's not going to happen. So I just have to learn my lines and not get into doing it in a place which is not there. I'll only do it when I get to set and we'll work it out there.
And also the big problem with the industry world over is that we all try to decode success, like a performance that you have liked, but no one knew that it's going to be good. So you have to be true to your thing. Maybe in your class someone else is very spontaneous, but if you're not, please don't be spontaneous. It's not going to help you. Only you are going to help you. So, but of course, it all is good to like understand, chat, and keep it in the back of your mind. But you can only do what you can do.
You just
have to try to know yourself.
Yeah.
And to quickly jump in and also like to add to what both these guys are saying, I feel like also in my experience at least, I feel kabhi kabhi kya hota hai na ki different characters require different approaches. Like it could be I'm playing a historical character or I'm working on a character which has a particular accent. Like I did a show in which I'm supposed to play a Bihari village woman who doesn't know certain English words, who only knows certain, and wo shirt ko sir bolti hai. And because you're so hardwired sometimes, so in that case, sometimes it is important to maybe find a rhythm, but that is only for that character. So that's a very specific thing. But most often it's like, if you just know your lines without attaching too much thought or emotion to it, it's like Ram Ruk Mat Chal. Ram Ruk Mat Chal. Now these are two completely different things. It just depends on how you are. तो टेक्निकल हो गया बट ऐसे ही मतलब समझाने के लिए तो आई मीन बट अगर वो शब्द याद कर लोगे ना फिर मजा क्या आएगा कि जाके खेलो देन समटाइम्स यू विल आल्सो सरप्राइज योरसेल्फ बिकॉज़
करेक्ट
इट्स दैट
बट इज राइट इज एवरीबॉडीज ओन प्रोसेस
या प्लीज
एक्टिंग इज वेरी इंडिविजुअल मैन इट वर्क डिफरेंटली फॉर हर नॉट डिफरेंटली फॉर मी इट माइट वर्क डिफरेंटली फॉर यू दैट रिहर्सल एंड माइट वर्क फॉर यू आई हैव टू फाइंड something about me. Correct. And I'm always finding it.
Yeah,
I find it everything I do.
And you're always first looking around people who have made it.
Like you talked about like how you are a person and how is the character, there is difference, and our sir also tells condition break or condition
break.
So I'm sure like you guys might have also probably thought about your backstories and written down that.
Do that, but don't ever show backstory to director. Every director hates it from their.
And never ask your director, "Mera motivation kya hai, sir?"
Backstories.
Hi.
Then for you, ma'am, post Vasepur, how have you feel the life, the graph of your life has been, like in terms of casting and in terms of popularity? Like Vasepur was a big break, obviously. So then you did Chicken Purana, then Badlapur. So how do you feel the casting before Vasepur for you, as in the roles you were getting, the scripts you were getting, and then post Vasepur has been for you?
Oh, I think Vasepur is not the right example, because I feel ki jab main Delhi se Bombay aayi and I started, I think till I would say Deedish Kya, which is I think my fifth release. I've always gone and auditioned for films and I've got those parts. So I think Lavsha was the only one I didn't audition for, only because I'd already worked with on Gangs of Vasepur, and earlier somebody else was supposed to do that film and that person didn't end up doing it, and then it came to me. Uske alawa chahe D-Day ho, chahe Deedish Kya ho, Ek Thi Diana ho, these are all films I tested for, and you know, that's how I got the films. So I think post that, I would say, is then when I started getting offers, which is because I think by that time people had seen enough work of mine that was out there. But popularity to pata nahi, I don't know, but the popularity to, I think Gangs itself was such an iconic film that I think, you know, one day I just woke up and people knew me. So it was quite bizarre, and I had not expected it, because what happens, you know, sometimes when you're starting off, like when I came from Delhi to Bombay, I wanted to do one film. Ek picture karni thi, because you know, you want to do one film, and then your planning is only till they're doing that one film. And then after that, you don't know, because you've not thought that far, because you never somehow believe that you'll make that far. So after that, I feel like maybe I lost myself, because I was also like not sure of what kind of actor I wanted to be. Or maybe I was not listening to my own strengths, which I'm sure all of us as artists will go through that journey of finding ourselves and losing ourselves and finding ourselves again and making mistakes. And I think I've made my fair share of those mistakes. So then I think COVID happened. I think that's been a big, at least for me and my mental health, and what just realizing what I wanted to do and who I was, and making choices like that were going in a certain direction. So I think.
Also, one more thing, like, at which point of your life, career, like, in terms of film, you felt like, I have decoded the part success, ki, haan, ye karne se, I'm getting.
Success ka koi code hota hi nahi hai. I wish aisa hota. I think the only thing I've cracked for myself is I have to wake up every day and go to work. Just wake up every day and just go to work. There is no other formula to it. And there'll be things that you work so hard for. And you'll put all your heart and soul and physical torture and everything, but they'll not give you anything. And there'll be things that you feel are easy. Hai. And that'll somehow become this phenomena. So there is, and it's very weird, like life is very strange. So there is no like formula to it. There is no formula to becoming a star. There is no formula to becoming, you know, famous. There is no formula to getting by people, certain actors you like, or their faces, or their performance. There is no formula to this. The only thing in your hand is your craft, is to build your skill set as an actor. That is in your hand. And some people will end up becoming stars and some people won't. But again, like there is no dawai, there is no medicine for it.
Most will end up not becoming stars. Most.
But also, like, I've reached a point where it's not even important.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like,
correct,
you know, what is important for you is, like, if you're going to work, are you happy with what you did today?
Yeah, yeah.
And, like, am I happy with my choices that I'm making? And, you know, those are important things, yeah, to you, so.
Well, also, they always see, you know, when Kashyap had said, na, when Kashyap had called the entire cast of LSD, there were so many young actors in it. And everyone was hustling except Rajkumar. He was just standing quiet, so he got cast in Vasepur. Everyone who jisne kaan chabaya Anurag ka, no one was cast.
Right.
So there is a point where you hustle, there is a point where you make your presence felt. Right. But just be assured with yourself.
Right.
Be who you are.
To shayad ho jayega, shayad. It's a kuch guarantee.
Correct.
Yeah.
And also I think it's more important that the choice of this career should be driven, because I think we should all fall in love with the craft and the process of making cinema rather than stardom and fame.
Yeah, yeah. Because that though will never happen.
But I understand, like, because I've also been where you guys are. Like, you know, we've all been there. So I feel like it's, everybody wants to become Shah Rukh Khan.
Yeah.
You know, we all love this story of just coming with a bag. That's, and then just being the biggest superstar in the country. And there's nothing wrong in having that desire. But I feel like like I say, like, you know, it may happen, it may not happen. That's not in your hand. The only thing in your hand is, are you enjoying to live and to enjoy and to, you know, work with people who are also fueling your passion, like, and yeah.
We noticed that in Hollywood there are a lot of actor directors, like they play both the parts in a movie. In Hindi industry, we don't see it as much.
I mean, we had all the greats, yeah, Gurudutt, Raj Kapoor, and we had them.
Nowadays,
there is Farhan as well.
Yeah, but I think not as much as we see in Hollywood. In your experience, any particular reason for that?
No, there's no, who will know, aapne ko apna career nahi pata hai. But y'all can change that. No, but I've seen so many actors who, when they don't find work that interests them, they create work for themselves. Mm. Like Zeeshan Qadri, he wanted to become an actor. So, and he had just one story to say, his neighborhood. He got it. First he went to all directors, then he went to Hansal Mehta. Mm. Then he, I think Hansal wasn't doing it. Then he met, Anurag outside Prithvi, he said, "Le lo, but mere ko ek role de do." But then Anurag's amazing like that. Even Raja Chaudhary did the same.
Yes.
He came with the script of Gulal. Vineet did the same. He came with the script of Mukkabaz. So, kar to sakte ho. Matlab, wo actor director nahi the, but director ke paas apna khud ka role likh ke gaye the. So,
it's like Rocky.
So, you never know. Yeah. Matlab, you can change your destiny for yourself. Just see how hard the world has punched you down and then you see how hard you can come up. So, वैसी extreme situations भी होता है ये सब. आसानी से चार ad मिल जाएंगे, कपड़े ले लेगा, गाड़ी ले लेगा, ये सब नहीं आएगा ख्याल. Like, you know, till the time you're being punched.
Punched.
Hello. Sir, my question is to you, Vasan sir. So as a director, when you lock a script or when you lock a story, and then the question is divided in two parts. First is, do you have an exact clear picture of how it is going to transcend to the screen and how it is exactly going to look? Do you have that?
Exactly. No. Which is what I'm saying. The larger question is, what is exact?
Okay, so for me, exact is, suppose when I'm reading a story, I'm getting the visuals in my head, suppose. So I exactly want that to transcend to the screen. Is it the same process?
Do you remember your exact visual also in your mind?
Okay.
How clear is that visual? Kitne logon ka button kitna tha pata hai kya? When that visual is coming, is they wearing a t-shirt or a shirt? Do you know exactly that? You'll never know.
Okay, so
there is nothing exact, there is no perfection. It is the vision. Vision is a much larger thing. When you go to micromanagement, utna achha ban sakta hai. But I think the vision is a much larger thing to kind of let in flaws, to let in the good things, let in the bad things, and somehow take it a larger shape.
And sir, my part B of this question would be that since filmmaking or cinema is such a collaborative art form, so like as a director, you are in charge of everything. So how do you make sure that the entire crew is on the same line? How do you like have this communication?
So one is, if you feel there is enough respect given to each other, then we are already on the same page. And then there is, you don't, matlab sabko dara dhamka ke mat rakho ki main jo bol raha hu wahi karo. Ye to fir kuch banega nahi. So give everyone enough leeway to approach everything. But of course, also it can't be overpowering also, because then suddenly everyone's talking, that also doesn't work. So there is a balance. I think once the respect and the love and, you know, the dignity is set na, to I think kahin na kahin wo sab log ek dusre ko samajhne zyada lagte hain. Aap apne, you will get your space, you will give the others their space, and somehow we'll arrive at a more healthier way of trying to achieve what we set. But if it is too like rigid from day one, I don't think then he will also not have the mood, she won't have the mood to give also. Or she will come in too aggressively with ideas. And then that will also not work, na? I don't know how to receive an aggressive idea. Or so I think the balance is ki yaar, ek, just a general atmosphere of trust. and then maybe you might just you know, work around and see where it goes. I'm sorry, you are both vague, the Mosho type bol raha hu, but wohi sach hai. There is no exact, there is no perfection, there is no perfect light, there is no perfect. But you can chase it. Matlab aisa kuch nahi hai ki bol diya to mat chase karo. If you feel like that, you should.
We'll take one last question. No? Gunmanti.
I have a question for you, sir. आपने कहा कि वो जेम्स वगैरह खा रहे हैं वो इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं है लिखना बैक स्टोरी में, तो कैरेक्टर को समझने के लिए क्या कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स पता होना जरूरी है आपके अकॉर्डिंग?
सो आई थिंक वही ओवरऑल, मतलब हैबिट सिर्फ कैरेक्टर नहीं बताता.
करेक्ट.
हाँ, मतलब कि गांधी जी बकरी का दूध पीते थे, उससे थोड़ी पता है कि वो सत्याग्रह करने वाले. मतलब सही ढंग पे नहीं होती तो कुछ भी हो सकता है. एंड दूसरा, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द डायरेक्टर कि क्या बोल रहे हैं, और अगर लग रहा है कि वहां भी बात नहीं बननी ना तो अपना ही करो. एकदम सेल्फिश हो जाओ कि यार ये फिल्म का कुछ नहीं होने वाला, मैं अच्छी एक्टिंग कर लूंगी. आई थिंक यू हैव दैट इन यू.
बट जैसे आपने कहा कि आप ज्यादा एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं देते हो.
हां हां हां, मतलब आई थिंक
अगर एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं,
आई होप आई फील आई गिव इनफ.
ओके,
इनफ. मतलब कभी कभी क्या होता है ना, वो एक्सप्लेन करने में भी इतना मजा आता है ना कि देन यू आर डिक्टेटिंग थिंग्स, यू आर ओवरपावरिंग. आई थिंक वो ओवरपावरिंग से कोलैबोरेशन इज बेटर. तो आपको हर तरह के डायरेक्टर मिलेंगे और मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि आप सबको हैंडल कर लोगे.
I have a question for you though, related. What if the tone is only
like I don't know why, like these two people I'll remember.
Who, which two?
I don't know why.
Which two? This one and
him, and him probably is a South Indian.
Okay. No, but I have a question. Suppose the tone is only wrong.
Her and him.
Her and him. The tone is only wrong. Supposing, like, haan, as she's saying, that not giving, you are not giving too many instructions.
Exactly,
right?
Exactly.
Now, our scene that we were doing,
haan, haan, haan.
Suppose the, haan, or हम लोग ने कोई बैटिंग रिहर्सल भी नहीं किए,
हम
लोग ने रीडिंग्स भी नहीं किए, तो एंट्री हुई,
हाँ हाँ,
और बंदे का सुर ही डिफरेंट है फुल,
हाँ,
फिर अभी और उसको आ नहीं रहा जो आपको चाहिए,
तो आई थिंक सी उसके बाद इफ आई एम इंस्ट्रक्टिंग समवन टू मच, मतलब बहुत खराब एक्टर है.
अगर तो आपने अगर आप
अगर जिसके साथ बहुत प्यार से बात कर रहा हूँ बहुत देर तक.
अच्छा, तो समझ में आया कि ये साथ
मतलब इनडायरेक्टली ऑल आर गेटिंग कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स दैट वेरी गुड एक्टर,
कि हमसे बात ही नहीं करते थे.
If you're bad, then you have to, मतलब मेरा बाकी सब काम गया बाड़ में.
हाँ,
इसके साथ बैठ के
प्यार से बात कर रहा हूँ मैं. But okay,
then you're done. कुछ कर,
then you're done. And I think don't hold back your personality. Be selfish. बहुत जरूरी नहीं है कि बहुत से लोग हैं. All the there are so many actors जो अपने personality के दम पे आगे निकले हैं. और उससे ना कभी मत छुपो. ज़्यादा character writer भी कभी-कभी role अगर छोटा हो in that sense अपने आप को बेचो. Don't worry about the character. वो बहुत काम आता है यार. मतलब यू सी इरफान, यू सी नवाज, मतलब वो पॉकेट भी मारा तो उसने अपना दिया ना. एक सीन यार इन सरफरोश, द वे ही क्राइड, थोड़ी सोचा होगा क्या कैरेक्टर है, बस यार मैं कमाल रोता हूँ मैं रो दूंगा. यू नो, पुट योर, मतलब पुट योर बेस्ट फुट फॉरवर्ड. यू रिमेंबर दैट वन सीन एज टू हाउ इज दिस गाय क्राइंग. थोड़ी जॉन मैथ्यू मतान ने बोला होगा ऐसे रो, वो तो नवाज ने बोला होगा अब मैं खाऊंगा, लाइक यू नो आई विल क्राई, आई विल क्राई माय बेस्ट. So I think it is that, yeah, just put your best foot forward. Of course, if you're the lead, then you will get all the material because sabki phadi padi hai na, you're like, it's depending on you. But if you have small opportunities, put yourself. Put yourself in the sense, not overpowering things, but be like, you can sit there and maybe you can hold. Maybe there is some sort of confidence in her, like, or the gaze, or you know, something that holds. Just give it that. Wo camera pakad leta hai, और वो एडिट में आ जाते हैं.
ग्रेट.
Thank you.
For us right now, I know that we have to do a lot of preparation, but Mr. Bala, he mentioned a very good thing that sometimes we will get some small roles, okay, where there is not much background or not much dialogues. So whatever I'm best at, like for example, he mentioned that there was a scene in the movie Sarfarosh. Just right now, I attended an amazing session with Huma ma'am and Bala sir and Sikandar sir. And of course, they answered a lot of our questions, a lot of things that we thought happened a different way, but they showed us how it works behind the camera. Because we also learned a lot about it, but they gave us a detailed view about how things actually work in the reality. One thing I learned and loved about was Sikandar sir said that he practiced a line of it and there were so many names, it was a very long line something, and he just practiced, kept on practicing it, and when he actually went to give the shot, he was like, he got confused and he just messed up. But it also inspired, and he was like very inspirational, very casual about it to inspire us that it's okay if you make mistakes, it's okay.
But one thing which you know, struck me when Sikandar sir had mentioned that when he gets a script, he just doesn't only read his part, he goes through the entire script, and that's not it. He goes through it once, then again, and again. You subconsciously start absorbing those little things and it actually reflects in your performance.
The biggest takeaway from this guest lecture for me would be how to decode a script. The actors spoke about their processes and how important it is for us as actors to find our process. Another very important takeaway which Vasan Bala sir said was that improvisation creates magic on screen, and as an actor it's very important to learn how to create those moments.
So just small details about how a film is made from the beginning to the end, and to hear it from actors themselves is really interesting, because we only see the final product, we don't really understand the actual process.
I was very excited because I wanted to know that you एक्टर बन जाते हो और एक लेवल पे पहुंच जाते हो तो क्या क्या चीजें होती है जो आपकी ट्रेनिंग की होती है जो काम आती है एज एन एक्टर उस टाइम पे सेट पे. सो हुमा कुरैशी मैम हो गई, वसन बाला सर हो गए, सिकंदर सर हो गए, इन लोगों ने काफी सारे एक्सपीरियंसेस हमारे साथ शेयर किए.
I mean, it was a wonderful experience. Thank you, ActorPrepares, for this.
Thank you so much, ActorPrepares, and we're looking forward to more guest lectures.
Thank you, ActorPrepares, for organizing this. It was really knowledgeable.
ActorPrepares को मैं बहुत बड़ा thanks बोलना चाहूँगी. मैं अनुपम सर को बहुत बड़ा thanks बोलना चाहूँगी कि मैं यहाँ पर आ पाई और ये तीन महीने मैंने किस तरह बिताए यहाँ पर. एक एक दिन मेरे लिए बहुत important था. ये training जो है हमेशा मेरे काम आने वाली है और हमेशा मुझे याद आने वाली.
And this is an inside joke that we want to share with you guys, just you guys. Chala bada, chala bada.